ma'am, I am Sri Lakshmi Kantamma, Social CRT, working in KGBV Maripadu. Today, I am here to teach you the first chapter of 7th class, reading maps of different kinds.
What is a map? A map is the representation of whole earth or a part of it on a flat surface according to its proportionate scale. There are some components of map. They are directions, scale, symbols and colors. Coming to the first component, directions. We have four major directions and four subdirections. The major directions are north, south, east, and west. North, south, east, and west. Four subdirections are in between north and east, northeast. In between north and west, northwest. In between south and east, southeast. In between south and west, southwest. In a map, directions are like this. To the top of the map, it is north. To the bottom of the map, it is south. To the right side of the map, it is east. To the left side of the map, it is west. Now, let's see some questions based on directions. First question. Krishna Reddy went to Bhopal from Hyderabad. In which direction did he travel? Krishna Reddy went to Bhopal from Hyderabad. From Hyderabad to Bhopal. Hyderabad is capital city of Telangana. And Bhopal is capital city of Madhya Pradesh. He traveled towards the top of the map. It is north direction. Krishna Reddy traveled towards north direction. Next question. Ashok went to Chennai from Lucknow. In which direction did he travel? Ashok went to Chennai from Lucknow. From Lucknow to Chennai. Lucknow is the capital city of Uttar Pradesh. And Chennai is the capital city of Tamil Nadu. He traveled towards bottom of the map. So, it is south direction. Ashok traveled towards south. Next question. Regina went to Bhuvaneshwar from Mumbai. In which direction did she travel? Regina went to Bhuvaneshwar from Mumbai. From Mumbai to Bhuvaneshwar. Mumbai is capital city of Maharashtra. Bhuvaneshwar is capital city of Odisha. She travels towards right side in map. So, it is east direction. Regina travel towards east direction. Vaprachu went to Jaipur from Kohima. In which direction did he travel? Vaprachu went to Jaipur from Kohima. From Kohima to Jaipur. Kohima is the capital city of Nagaland. Jaipur is the capital city of Rajasthan. He traveled towards left direction. So, it is west direction. Vaprachu travel towards west. Next question. Make such questions and ask each other. Create some more questions like this and write answer for them by your own. Next question. Look at the symbols shown on the map. Now, try to find out the boundaries of Andhra Pradesh. Symbols used in this map are given in the table. boundaries of India are dark lines and state boundaries are light lines. Capitals are indicated with dots. You all know AP in India map. It is to the south of Odisha and north of Tamil Nadu. Here it is next question. Draw the symbol for the boundary of a state and the boundary of India in your notebook. See that index table, there are symbols. Draw it in your notes. Next question. Can you make a list of states which lies to north, south, west of Andhra Pradesh? What lies to the east of the state? To the north of Andhra Pradesh, we have Odisha. Chhattisgarh and Telangana. To the west of Andhra Pradesh, we have Karnataka. To the south of Andhra Pradesh, we have Tamil Nadu. To the east, it is Bay of Bengal. Next question, in class 6th, you have learned to measure distances using scale. Now try to measure distance between Hyderabad and various state capitals like Jaipur, Imphal, Gandhinagar and Thiruvananthapuram. You have learnt about scale in class 6th. Scale is the ratio of distance on a map to corresponding distance on actual ground. Scale is the ratio of distance on a map to corresponding distance on actual ground. In your textbook, open page number 3. Take a scale and measure the distance between Hyderabad and Jaipur. You get 6 centimeters. Here, scale is given that 1 centimeter equal 200 kilometers. So, distance between Hyderabad and Jaipur is 6 × 200 km equal 1200 km. Similarly, find distance between some other places. Now, coming to the next component, symbols. Symbols are used to show any physical objects on the map. They are represented using letters or shapes. In class 6th, you have learnt about some symbols. Let's see them. Here, if you see the symbols of railways, Kachcha Road, Pakka Road, trees, houses, rivers, masjid, church, temple, school, police station, railway station, and post office, etc. etc. are given. Now, in class 7, we have 3 major symbols. They are point, line, and area. First of all, point. Point is used to show particular places in a map like Hyderabad, Chennai, Mumbai, Kolkata, etc. Here in first map, capitals are marked with points. Second one is line. It is used to represent the boundaries of states or countries and rivers. In the first map, lines are used for boundaries of states and boundaries of India. Coming to the third one, area. It is used to represent a specific region of space with colors or pattern. Here, in second map, each and every state is colored with different colors. It is also known as real symbols. Now, coming to the types of maps, we have 3 types of maps: political map, thematic map, and physical map. First, coming to political map. maps showing villages, towns, cities, districts, states and countries with their boundaries are called political maps. Now, let's see some political maps. It is the political map of India. In this map, we have state and capitals. And it is the political map of Andhra Pradesh. The second type of map is thematic map. These maps are used to show the distribution of specific features such as land use, temperature, rainfall, population, soils, natural vegetation, crops, minerals, industries, railways, roads, waterways, etc. Let's see the thematic map of India showing the rice production in India. This shows the rainfall. Coming to the physical map. These maps showing the physical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, oceans, rivers, etc. These maps showing the physical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, oceans and rivers, etc. In these maps, you will usually find a different part of land colored with green, yellow and brown, showing variations in the ground and water bodies are colored in blue. Now, let's see the physical map of India. This map is showing mountains. Plateaus, plains, etc. Okay. Now, let's recall what we have learnt in this class. First one, directions. We have learnt four major directions and four subdirections. And we have also discussed some questions based on directions. Second one, scale. We have discussed few points about scale and learnt how to measure distance between any two places using map. Symbols. We recalled the symbols of class 6 and also discussed about point, line and area. We have also discussed about different kinds of maps. They are political map, thematic map, physical map. We have also seen some examples for these maps. Okay, thank you. Let's continue lesson in our next class.